Yo, what's up, guys? Still here in Los Angeles. I'm going to talk about the new Interplanetarian Server Arena battle thing, whatever it's called. So, it is coming this Sunday. This video is probably posted either on the Friday or the Saturday. And I'm going to talk about what kind of defenses should be run, or not necessarily what kind of defense should be run, because this would probably need some LDs for that. Also, the light's pretty weird, but it's either this or this. So, I went for this, I guess. It's my last day here in LA. So, talking about the defenses, what is going to be good? What do I think is going to be good? A lot of stuff that works for Arena Rush is probably not going to be that great for the Interplanetarian kind of stuff. Main reason for that is a defense like this on Rush might be good. Okay, sure, it's going to be outspent and therefore it's not that great. But anything stall, like look for example at this. This is pretty stall. But if you put like four bruisers against this, you're very likely going to be able to kill this without any problems. The only kill potential on this whole team is Kiki. Moment you get rid of that, the unit is already dead. You could literally attack this with a Molong Balfrek, both on Swift. You kill that unit, and then you're playing a four against three, and you hit it with that. So a whole bunch of things with these offenses you got to keep in mind. A whole bunch of things. Like your defense has to have so much stuff. The light's actually really bad. Holy, maybe I should do it like this. Should do it like this. Does that make it a little bit better? It does, but I can't do that permanently now because I'm holding my head. Okay, whatever. Doesn't matter about me anyways, it's about the defenses. So the thing is, if you hit any or if you create a defense, there's so many things you gotta keep in account. It should not be Lucianable. It shouldn't be Tianable. It shouldn't not be one-shotable like Copper Bulldozer. I actually think Copper Bulldozers are gonna be pretty legit offense for this stuff as well. I think people are going to bruiser a lot. So you have to keep so many things in mind. But the best thing for this defense that you should do is I think the best thing you can create is something that you know is hard countered by X. And you know people are going to X you or something. And when you have that in mind, you build exactly anti-counter on that. And therefore people will lose to you. Since they can only hit once, they don't have redos. Because in Siege you have a redo, in Arena Offense you have a redo, in RTA you might play against the same player again. In the Interplanetary Server Battle kind of thing, there's only a one try. So if they mess up the one try, I'm sure they can tell their friends and the other ones that are in the same bracket, like, hey, this is this and this kind of defense. But I think the most amount of wins you can actually pick is going for trap stuff. But what actually is trap stuff? How do you set up a trap? I am not 100% sure about that. That part, I am not too sure about. You could go for something like this, saying like, okay, I expect to be Lucian, and therefore everything is very tanky, everything is very minus the wind on the artifacts and that kind of stuff. But this, I wouldn't bruiser. I would literally, I'm pretty much planning to go for a team that is probably Molong, Balfrek, Swift sets. Wait, where's my Molong? Oh, my Molong is in here somewhere, Molong. So if you go these two units plus a speed booster and then something to make it safe as third pick, you're gonna be fighting 4v3s on everything that has no speed leads, pretty much. So those are kind of offenses to keep in mind. As long as you one shot and you make it a 4 against 3, you are very likely to win. Also, an offense I've been toying around with is this. This is pretty much just super bruiser, super siege meta kind of related stuff. Really look at your siege units. What kind of siege units do you use? What kind can you actually fit in there to actually have it work itself? You know, those keep on rolling, always farming, boys. You know what it is. But the main recommendation also for offense is going to be do not focus too much on your normal offenses. Actually go for safe clears. Do take your time, hit those 50 wings, at least if you want to be, well, playing effective in it. That's also you're working with like a whole bunch of other people, which might mess things up, but I think every defense has like legit counters to it. For example, this could be kind of tricky. There is a few things that makes this kind of tricky, right? Well, let's actually give it a swirl on this. I'm not sure if this is going to work. I do not think so, actually. But the thing is, you're also working with AI, and AI is not so smart, which helped me out quite a bit. Is that Vert triple revenge? Yes, that Vert is triple revenge, actually. So with this, a bunch of bruiser metas. I think this is actually better against some things that, because I have multiple destroyers on it, That's also something to think about. If you're building your defense, do you want to put units on destroy or not? I think actually one or two units in your siege defense on destroy is going to be very good, because if people are running these kind of offenses, you want to have destroy on your units, because otherwise your units are never going to kill anything. Actually, some server siege meta, well, I think some siege meta in the top anywhere right now is having like two or three out of the three units on destroy. That is something that I would actually recommend to go for this as well. I'm gonna kill the Kinky actually. That's going to be an issue. I think I have to stun it, because otherwise he's gonna heal more than I hit for. And I have to kill or keep the Clara alive. But wait, I have destroy, so I'll kill it anyways. Nah, so yeah, that's the thing, that also the offenses will probably have destroy. But if he would have destroyed more HP than I would have destroyed, then I actually would have had an issue. Currently, it's not a big issue. But those are things to keep in mind. So there's a whole bunch of things to keep in mind. Also, a good thing to do is test with your friends. Not necessarily by going into the actual match, but just saying like, yo, I have this and this defense. How would you hit it? And just talk about that kind of stuff. Like if you talk about stuff like, hey, how would you hit this? Everyone is gonna come up with like a few other ideas to actually hit it. So the same as you probably do in your siege guild, and if not, you should do in your siege guild, is talk about what kind of offenses make sense, what would help you to have a more effective way of winning or anything. And this light is really so weird. But yeah, I am expecting a lot of people to go for these kind of offenses, very bruiser heavy, so you might want to have a destroy rune in there, but therefore it also becomes more difficult again to actually have a, what's it called, a defense that does enough damage, is fast enough, and that kind of stuff, because you're working pretty much in a siege meta, but then for, well, 5 stars always, but you're working with 4 units and you have different speed leads, which actually add up to quite some. For example, defense like this in rush, it can be pretty good. If it's tanky enough, it's pretty good. I am also pretty sure that if I put this team to it and I press auto and I walk away for like half an hour, I can come back and this team is very dead. So that is the thing that you don't want to really use. You don't really want to use anything like super stall that you think like, okay, if I just put something very tanky will probably often still be killed. A lot of things can actually still be illusioned here and there. If you do, yeah, that's still a case, that's still a thing. But full on stall defenses would not recommend. I would totally recommend for any defense. So key things you want to have is you want to have a threat which is able to kill one or two things at least. You want to have probably some form of sustain, but I'm not actually sure if that's 100% a must. I think the speed leads are going to be so much more beneficial than the HP leads, but if you don't have any of the speed leads, then sure, HP lead is probably best bet. Or since it's kind of bruiser heavy, going resistance lead might actually also be pretty good. I actually think resistance lead, as long as you're not Lucianable, not, you know, all of that kind of shebangable. If you have a resistance lead, especially at some of the lower ranks, I actually think just going a Tessarion in there. If you go Tessarion, you already counter Leo. You have a resistance lead. You already counter a bunch of things. Technically, you already counter Lucians. So a Tessarion lead is actually a very good option for people that do not have any of the good speed leads or anything like that. So try to look at these kind of units, see what kind of units you have. And the best thing is, if it surprises the enemy, if it has most RNG, it is most likely to win. So keep those in mind. Have a bit of everything. Do not be countered by everything that would be a standard hit. Lucian, Coppers, Molong, Swifts. Oh man, this is going to be so difficult to craft a defense. I'm not even sure what my defense is going to be yet. I'm first figuring out that this rush is going to be super mental in EU server, because EU server is always active on rushing, like very active on rushing. This is going to be the most crazy active rush ever. I already notice it like throughout the week. I get like literally like, I get 10 hits by like 2 hours or like 1 hour. And it's not even like it's 3 days before rush. It's crazy, man. So yeah, keep those things in mind. Also, try to craft something with your friends, because this is something that is so dynamic. There's so many options. There's so many offenses. You are not going to be able to think about all of the options, and especially if you're higher in some of the servers, actually talk to the people that get legend, talk to the people that are very good in Siege. I think Siege players are actually better at this probably than arena offense players or arena defense players. So talk to those kind of people, see what they think about it, see what you can like strategize that you do similar teams, because the option for them is you could actually rerun for every offense you hit. So if you hit like, I'm not even sure if you have to hit everything once, or you can skip a few people. I'm not 100% sure about that. But there's so many options for them to hit offense if it's a 4v4 in a Guild Wars Let's Siege kind of meta. Do keep in mind you have the draw button in there, I think. I'm not even sure. I also think the tower that's all the way far over there, that tower is still hitting. So if they go for a non-sport kind of team, they might get fucked by that, but I'm not 100% sure about that if that thing is still in there. I do think so. This fight is probably going to take forever, but hey, you got 50 wings for like, you got a whole week for 50 wings. If you just do like 7 or 8 wings a day, 8 wings a day, you're already done for like the whole week. So that's pretty cool. I'm pretty hyped about it. I think it's going to be pretty cool content in general. I think I destroy quite some, but I don't destroy enough. Oh, what a struggle, what a fuck fest. Yeah, so I'm not gonna make you waste all your time with ending all of this thing, but keep those things in mind. It's not going to be easy, but it's not going to be easy for anyone. Also, for the question I get a lot, is EU going to be doing best in this? I'm not sure. If we had a pure rush kind of thing, I would say EU would be best. I could be saying hands down EU would be best. But since this is a kind of siege kind of thing, and it's based on rune quality and more on the unit box that you have, I actually give a lot of chances to servers that might have like higher rune quality. Thing is, it's very difficult to say like which server has better rune quality because besides RTA, you don't really see it too much. Like who has what kind of rune quality, who would have be better in Siege, who would be better in Arena. I just know that EU is more used to doing Arena. This fight is really dragging on really long. Okay, let's say if you destroy a lot, you still have a maximum amount of what you can destroy, and you have to actually kill something at some point. Oh, what the fuck fest, man. This fight is gonna take me hours, but I'm not losing it. I'm not losing it. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Next video is going to be, I think, the LA meetup story time, which is going to be a very fun one. So stay tuned for that. It's either the next one or the one after. So stay tuned for that one. Guys, see you here. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.